Hi, BitLoony here. Let's finalize this CRT boy today. There are several issues that I want to fix. For convenience, I will do this on a big screen with the composite input. First of all, there was a small bug that played noise whenever I selected anything else in music A. Oof. And that was easy to fix. The problem was that I ran out of space during the development, so I removed the other music. Now it's just silence. There are still some other tracks, but that's not how the real game works. During the end sequence, the rockets are too noisy and too loud. So I fixed that simply by reducing the amplitude. This is much better now. Now to the main task, to scale up the image to full screen. After a short investigation, I remembered why I chose this picture size. To be able to play the two-player mode like I did in my game controller tutorial, the fields need to be shown side by side. And this fills the complete horizontal space. Since the CRT boy doesn't have a link connection, we can ignore the two-player mode and scale the image up. The CRT boy uses a PAL composite signal. And this is the actual usable resolution. The original Game Boy uses 160 by 144 pixels. If we look closer, we can see that the vertical resolution fits 3 times into the PAL resolution. The horizontal resolution would even fit 4 times. And that's why I double the size of the pixels currently. It fits two screens side by side. To fill the screen and get a nice scaling without any artifacts, we can scale it by 3. I added additional functions on the driver layer to use the third of the resolution here. With the interlacing it's a bit more complicated, but the horizontal resolution simply writes 3 pixels of the same color. So let's test it.
Oh yes! Okay.
The two-player mode doesn't work anymore since the second field is off-screen. But that doesn't really matter for the CRT boy. Here is a comparison of the two different scalings. Another disadvantage of this scaling is that we crop the Mars flyby in the end screens. The unscaled version has a nice cinema look. Okay, now that the software is fixed, we can update the CRT boy. Uploading.
Oh yes!
That's a difference. The image is still not filling the complete screen. Let's see if we can fix that in hardware. On the mainboard of the CRT there are several trimmers. They are even labeled like horizontal size here. Focus here. And vertical sync. Let's simply try it. Okay, that doesn't do much. This seems to be the vertical shift. The metal screwdriver screws with the screen. Use a plastic one if you have one. This one seems to be the size. Nice, so we can trim this to fill the screen. This is the horizontal size. This is the focus. And this seems to be some kind of cathode ray adjustment. Let's close it up and try it.
Oh yes.
Ah, that's nice. Way better than before. Okay, since I'm happy with the outcome now, this will be the last episode for the CRT boy. I will upload the changes for the scaling, but there seems to be a problem with the new integration for the ESP32. A stack also in the I2S driver. Since I want to make the CRT stuff an Arduino library, I have to rework this anyways. This will be independent of this project. If you want to use this version of the Tetris clone, you have to install an older ESP32 integration. As far as I remember, that was one that I had to download from the Git repository. But you should subscribe and tune in again to see updates on the CRT Arduino library. Thanks for watching, and I see you in the new year. Bye!